Okay, so we're moving right along with our discussion of imaginary numbers. So let's take a look at how imaginary numbers fit in with other types of numbers that we're already used to. We know, of course, that we have a group of real numbers. We're all familiar with real numbers. It's the numbers we've been using up until now. Real numbers can be whole numbers. They could be fractions. They could be decimals. They could even be irrational numbers, numbers that cannot be expressed as a fraction. Those are all real numbers. We've now added another group of numbers that are called imaginary numbers. Those are numbers that have in them the imaginary unit I. So I itself, or 2i, or 3i radical 2. And these are all imaginary numbers. They're actually called pure imaginary numbers. Well, we can also then come up with a set of numbers that are called complex numbers. And complex numbers are the kind of numbers we have if we actually combine real numbers and imaginary numbers together. So, for an example of a complex number, say 2 plus 3i. Okay, that's a combination of a real number and an imaginary number. Complex numbers have the form a plus bi. We're talking about complex numbers now. Complex numbers take the form a plus bi. This is actually called the standard form for a complex number. Those complex numbers, I'm going to go ahead and write it up here bigger, have two parts. Those two parts are this part here, the A part, which is your real number portion, and your BI portion, which is your pure imaginary portion. When we combine those two together, we get something called a complex number. And in the case of this standard form, A and B are real numbers. So we could come up with tons of different examples of complex numbers. The one I already gave you, 2 plus 3i, negative 4 minus 6i, where A is negative 4 and B is negative 6. In this one, A is 2, B is 3, right? How about a half plus 3/4 i? That's a complex number. Has two real numbers in it. 1/2, that's our a, and 3/4, which is our b. And the 1/2 is the real portion of the complex number, and our 3/4 i is the imaginary portion of our complex number. Okay? So that's what a complex number is. Again, this is standard form, so it is technically incorrect to write, when you have a complex number, to write the imaginary portion first. It's just a matter of form. There's nothing mathematically wrong with that. 2 plus 3i and 3i plus 2 are mathematically equal to each other. But in terms of format, we always write the real portion first. And we've done this before. If we had had a quadratic equation and I had written this, I think you would know that that was wrong, right? Or at least in the wrong form, because you would write that x squared plus 2x minus 12. It's just the standard way of doing things. Well, there's a standard way of doing things with complex numbers too, and that is to write the real number first. Okay? So we're going to always write our real number first in standard form. We're going to write it in a plus bi form. I should also point out to you that when a equals 0, what do I get? I have just the bi portion. So when a equals 0, like 2i, 5i, negative 6i, that gives us our pure imaginary number. Okay? And when b equals 0, all we have left in the standard form is the a, because 0 times I is still 0, right? So, we would get answers like 3, negative 4, and so on. And that would give us a real number. So actually, if you want to look at it this way, all numbers, whether they are pure imaginary or a real number or a complex number, are all complex numbers. We can write real numbers and pure imaginary numbers as complex numbers with the understanding that either A or B is zero. So that's just a definition here. No real problems to solve here. You just need to know what a complex number is because you're going to be seeing lots of them, and you need to understand standard form A plus BI. Thanks.